In this tutorial, we are going to understand Bootstrap Carousel responsive slider images. So stay tuned to know more on this topic. Hello and welcome to another new episode of Learning Simplified. In today's tutorial, we are going to understand Bootstrap Carousel responsive slider images. You may see that these are practically carousel responsive images with control panels and with captions. Now, these two arrows in this extreme right and extreme left, see if we click on here, next images will be taking place, and if we click on this left arrow icon, then we will be proceeding towards the previous image. And on the other hand, we can see we have some indicators. So these are the controls, and of course there is a caption over here. So these are the things that are going to be taught in this tutorial, and of course with some customization that will be discussed in our next tutorial. So the very first point that is about to be considered here is the code, where from to get the code. If you go back to google.com and look for Bootstrap Carousel, you will be taken into this official website of Carousel, and here you can see that the codings are present over here. First one is without any kind of control or without any kind of previous or next items. In the second case, you will be having two arrows here, the previous arrow and the next arrow. And in the next case, you will be having with indicators. That means in addition to the arrows present in the extreme left and extreme right, you have some indicators from where you may choose the desired image where you want to jump off. And of course, here you will get the full and finalized code, where you will see that the images itself, along with the previous and next button, along with the indicators, and along with these caption panels. So the very first thing is to bring on these codes from here. So all you need to do, you need to copy them to clipboard, and then you need to come back to your page index.html or wherever you want to place your Bootstrap Carousel, and inside a container fluid. And I have created a carousel holder here, a class name with carousel holder, and with a class name of no padding. Then I have created a div class called lg12. Inside this div class called lg12, I have pasted all those codes that I have copied from here. So this is the first thing that you need to know. The second thing is how to set the dimension of the images. Practically, in case of Bootstrap or any kind of responsive images, image is a little bit challenge. You need to take care of various display devices with, and that is why image is gonna be, I think, a little bit of challenge itself, setting the right dimension, right width and right height of the image. In my case, I have placed all those images in a dimension of 1400 pixels by 550 pixels or 500 pixels. We always select a particular dimension such that after having these carousel images, users can understand there are still some contents beneath these slider panels, beneath these slider images. As 768 is the lowest possible viewport height in case of a desktop application, so that is why I would like to suggest you to keep maintaining this dimension. That means 1400 pixels by 500 pixels. So the second part is setting the width or setting the dimension of the images. Now the third point is understanding all these parts that are present within this particular commands or syntaxes, those are being used over here. We have to understand all those things. Now, just look over here, we can see a DYD carousel example generic has been created. Practically, this is the ID that will be used all over. Here you can see that a well-class carousel indicators have been created. That means this part, these are this well-class carousel indicators. Those have been created over here, where we can see that a list item has been called in with a data target of the same ID that has been created over here. In the next thing, you will see that a data write has been used with a carousel class. That means here we are specifying that a carousel image slider has to be introduced in case of this DYD carousel example generic. And another thing, the number of list items will be the same the number of images being used over here. That means I am just reloading it once again. So this is the first image, this is the second, this is the third, fourth and fifth. That means five images are being used over here. If we get back to our project, we can see that here are five list items. Those are being created and those are being indexed starting from zero. That means the first image, that will be indexed as 0, the second one will be indexed as 1, the third one is will be indexed as 2, the fourth one will be indexed as 3, and the fifth one will be indexed as 4. Likewise, if you use 7 images over here, then it will be indexed accordingly as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That means a total of 7 images will be used here. We have understood this part. And we'll be talking about these things later. What is the purpose being served over here? In this deep class carousel inner, it has a role of list box. Then comes this deep class item active. That means if we reload, when the page is getting reloaded, the first image that is being loaded into your page will be this one. So this is the zeroth image is being loaded into your page. That thing is being observed over here. The same thing, we are here practically using deep class item active. That means this will be the first image. And on the other hand, if we look into this carousel indicators, we can see that data slide to zero, it is using the same class active. So this will be the first image that will be loaded when the page is being loaded for the first time, and in that case this particular indicator will be active in the same purpose. Now data slide to zero, this I have forgot to mention here, this actually tells you about sliding towards some particular images. As we can see here, data slide to zero, this is the first one. That means this image will be considered as number one, then it slides over to the next image and to the next, the fourth image and the fifth image. So all it is doing, it is just sliding your images to the next one accordingly. At the end of the slider, the image is getting rolled again from its previous, from the beginning position, from the starting position. So this thing is known as data cycling. In order to create this data cycling, all you need to do, you need to mention this data wrap as true. If we just change this thing to false, data wrap is now set to false. Now press Ctrl S, get back to your project and reload. And now just wait, see here what happens. This is the second, third image, fourth image, fifth image, and the cycle stops. Images are not getting rolled over again into its previous position, into the first image, because you have used here data wrap as false. That is why if you want to keep going on with your cycling, then all you need to do, you need to keep it to data wrap true. Now just get back to your project and reload. Now you can see this is the first one, second image, third image, fourth image, fifth image, and all over it is starting again. That means the cycle is getting started all over again. So this is the purpose of data wrap, as we can see here. And this thing is data interval. It actually determines the time delay of each images into that slider. It is actually counting the milliseconds in timing. That means if we want a 1 second delay, then all we need to do, we need to change it to 1000. Data interval, this is the attribute, and we are setting the time delay to 1000 milliseconds. That means 1 second. Reload. And now we can see that a 1 second data pause here. This is just a 1 second data pause. That means you are successfully changing your data interval over here. Reverting it back to its original value, it is 2000 milliseconds, that means 2 seconds, and the data wrap is true. That means this slider will cycle through. Now the final part is this captions over here. If we just get back to our first image over here, we can see that here is a caption and here is another paragraph over here. And that is why another particular div class is being used over here, which is known as carousel caption. Here we can see we are setting an h3 here, we are setting a p tag over here. So carousel caption is the div that will be used along to create such captions inside your images. And on the same way, in this same process, you can create a button over here, a sign in button. So these are the things that you need to keep in mind while you are creating your carousel images. Now there's a lot of things that is now about to be discussed, such as the customization. The first one is, if we just press Ctrl minus, we can see that this image is getting in the extreme left position. We need to make this image to take over all the 100% of its div that is it is residing now. The thing will be cleared over here. This is another project that is using the same carousel slider. Now if we press Ctrl minus here, now we can see practically this image is getting at 100% width. This thing could be very handy in many cases, especially while using cross-browser preview of the same project. So the fourth thing that is to be done in this particular case is customization of this carousel image slider. And this is the thing that is going to be discussed in our next tutorial. So stay tuned to our tutorials and subscribe us. If you like this video, then do not hesitate to hit that red subscribe button. Hope to see you guys in our next tutorial. Till then.